My name is Yogya Bhatia and I'm a legal intern at Lexis & Company. Today I'll be talking about International Criminal Court. The International Criminal Court was established in 2002 and it seeks to prosecute those who are guilty of serious international crimes like war crimes, genocide and crimes against humanity. It offers justice to the victims of the atrocities and deters the individuals from committing large-scale political crimes. On 1st July 2002, after receiving more than 60 ratifications, the court began its sittings. Its headquarters are in Netherlands at The Hague. ICC is different from the International Court of Justice as the ICC handles prosecution of individuals, whereas ICJ hears disputes between the states. The jurisdiction of the court extends to those offences which occurred after 1 July 2002 that were committed either by a national of the state that has ratified the agreement or in the state itself. But since its inception, the court has faced setbacks and it has been unable to get support from major powers including China, United Nations, Russia, etc. As human rights crises continue to increase rapidly, the mandate of ICJ is proved to be both intimidating and more needed than what its founders had envisioned. Although the Rome Statute was widely praised, some 140 countries had signed the agreement by the time it entered into force. Few countries in the Middle East or Asia are joined. Further, by 2002, China, Russia and the United States had declined to participate and the United States had threatened to withdraw its troops from the United Nations peacekeeping force unless its citizens, both military and civilian, were exempted from the prosecution of the ICC. Nevertheless, within 5 years of its sitting, more than 100 countries had ratified the treaty. All member countries are represented in the Assembly of State Parties which oversee the activities of the ICC. What are the court's origins? In the wake of World War II, Nuremberg Trials, the first international war crimes tribunal, was launched by the Allied powers to prosecute top Nazi officials. Until the 1990s, the governments did not coalesce around the idea of forming a permanent court to hold the individuals guilty for the world's most serious crimes. To deal with war crimes in Yugoslavia and Rwanda, the United Nations had set up HOC International Criminal Tribunals, but these tribunals were considered to be inefficient and inadequate by many international law experts. Trinidad and Tobago requested that the UN Commission look into the creation of permanent court in 1989. Such efforts gained support in the following years, especially in Europe and Africa. The European Union adopted a binding policy in support of the International Criminal Court in 2011. In July 1998, at a conference in Rome, the founding treaty of ICC was adopted by the UN General Assembly. In July 2001, the Rome Statute entered into the force after it was ratified by more than 60 countries. Which countries are members of the court? There are 123 countries which are party to the Rome Statute. Countries including Ethiopia, North Korea, Iraq, Turkey, Saudi Arabia, Indonesia, China and India never signed the treaty. Several dozen other countries signed the statute, but it was never ratified by the legislatures. These countries include Egypt, Israel, Iran, Sudan, Russia, Syria and the US. How does the court work? The ICC is based in The Hague, a city in the Netherlands that hosts many international institutions and has filed offices in several countries. The court does its investigative work through the Office of the Prosecutor, which is led by Fatou Bensouda, a lawyer from Gambia. There are 18 judges in the court. Each judge is from a different member country and is elected by the member states. The ICC requires that its members seek a gender balance bench and requires its judiciary to include representatives from each of the United Nations regions. The judges and prosecutors are elected for a term of 9 years and the same is non-renewable. The two vice presidents and the president of the court are elected from among the judges of the court. They handle the administration of the court along the registry. The court has jurisdiction over the following categories of crimes under international law. Genocide or the intention to destroy a national, ethnic, racial or religious group in whole or in part. War crimes or heinous breaches of the law of war, including prohibitions placed by the Geneva Conventions on torture and attacks on civilian targets such as schools and hospitals. Crimes against humanity or the violations committed through large scale attack against the civilian population or violations committed as a part of large scale attacks against civilian populations, including rape, slavery, torture, imprisonment and murder. Crimes of aggression or the use or threat of armed forces by a state against the territory integrity, sovereignty or political independence of another state or violation of the UN Charter. The court can start investigation into the crimes in one of these possible ways. Either a situation within the territory of the member country can be referred by such country to the court, or the UN Secretary Council may refer a situation or the prosecutor can suo motu launch an investigation into a member state. The court has the power to investigate individuals from the non-member states. If the offence alleged took place in the territory of a member state and if the non-member state accepts the jurisdiction of the court or with the authorization of the Security Council.